In late June 2006, the rain came in unending torrents, the likes which have not been seen in over 30 years. Over 1,000 Pennsylvania Guard members were activated to provide security, drinking water, and evacuate residents by ground and air. Over 1,000 water rescues were performed by National Guard helicopters. All in all, 46 of Pennsylvania's 67 counties were declared disaster areas. Pennsylvania Army and Air Guard members deployed in a truly joint mission, Operation Jumpstart, on the Arizona-Mexico border near Yuma.
So the National Guard is out there. They are our eyes and ears. And so it's been literally a great friendship to be able to have them here and operating with us hand in hand. The two main reasons I would say is first of all, they understand what a real world mission is. They go to Iraq, they're essentially fighting for the benefit of the United States, but they're helping out another country. They come here and they're immediately helping the United States and they're immediately seeing results. So it's a boost for them and it's a huge boost for us.
Guard members manned entry identification points and reported illegal aliens attempting to enter the country to United States Border Patrol officers. Otherwise balmy winter came to a screeching halt, along with traffic on three interstates, when the Valentine's Day blizzard struck on February 14th. Almost 1,000 Guard members responded, delivering food, fuel, and water to disconsolate drivers.
I'm trying to stay positive, but it helps when you see the copter and I seen you guys coming. It really builds morale, man.
Guard members also manned 44 traffic control points. About 5,000 meals were distributed. Diesel fuel was provided to stranded truck drivers. 175 military vehicles were used on Interstate 78, 80, and 81. The transformation of the 56th Stryker Brigade is on time and on target. Almost half of the vehicle commanders and drivers have been trained. 75% of the required training on the sophisticated information systems in the vehicles has also been accomplished.
Those guys, their entire year, almost everything they do has to do with learning how to operate this new equipment. It is labor intensive, it is generations ahead of the equipment that we used to have.
And the equipment has been installed in about 90% of the vehicles. Operational tests will be conducted in 2008. At Fort Indiantown Gap, the headquarters of the Pennsylvania National Guard, 14 major projects are currently underway. Over $150 million in construction projects include a battalion training complex, several new ranges, and infrastructure improvements.
The more realistic that we can make the training here, bottom line is, I'm hoping that it will save lives when they go to combat. And that's what it's all about. It's making these soldiers better prepared to do the mission that the country is asking them to do right now. That's what we're all about here at Fort Indiantown Gap.
The Department of Military and Veterans Affairs is pressing the United States Air Force and federal legislators to secure the Willow Grove Naval Air Station for use by the Pennsylvania Air National Guard's 111th Fighter Wing and possibly elements of the Pennsylvania Army National Guard.
We'd like to see the base expand, as we bring on the Army Reserve and hopefully the Army Guard. This base is in transition, so a lot of things are going to change, not only for our people, but obviously for those who come and stay. So there's going to be a lot of changes in the future.
In June of 2006, the 2nd Brigade Combat Team returned from a one-year deployment to Iraq. This was the largest deployment of the Pennsylvania National Guard since World War II.
Our brigade combat team either detained or killed over 2,400 insurgents during the year we were in Iraq.
I grew up a lot. They say a deployment adds 5 years to your maturity, and that's definitely true.
I actually think the locals were very thankful that we were there. there's a lot of good going on over there, and we are making a difference. So I hope that people will understand that and know that things aren't as bad as the media sometimes makes them seem.
Since 9/11, about 80% of the Pennsylvania National Guard has been deployed for the global war on terror. The cost has been high, 25 killed in action and over 250 wounded. In September, some 12,000 Guard members and families gathered at the Bryce Jordan Center in State College for some well-deserved recognition, good food, and great entertainment. Dubbed Operation Salute, thousands of volunteers from the State College area supported their Pennsylvania troops.
See, I want them to know that we support them, that no matter what they hear or anything else, that we appreciate everything that they're doing. Let's not eat that.
Fight for liberty, security, and the American way of life.